In this video, I'm going to discuss the percentage of completion method. And I know that there's probably some accountant somewhere in the universe that's going to see this thing, and he's going to probably chew me up one side and down the other and say, oh, well, gee, you don't know what the heck you're doing. Well, let me first say, I'm not an accountant, I'm a data processor. But the data processing field and the accounting field are interrelated. So I feel I do have some qualification to teach this. However, if I do make a mistake, by all means, leave me a comment or a video response, either way. Now, I'm going to turn my little camera around for just a second because I'm going to show you some things. All right, so hang on. Let me stack this down just a bit more. We may have to go down just a little bit more. Like this. Alright. Oh, that's much better. Now, I'm going to bear with me. There. Now you can see it all. Alright. So you can see here on the top, it says completion, percentage of completion method. Now, I really can't really draw a dividing sign here, but I'm going to say this right here. What you have here is a cost incurred to date. Now, let's say you're building a house, all right? And when you're building the house, you've got to buy boards, you've got to buy bricks, you've got to buy plumbing, you've got to buy hammers, you've got to buy nails, you've got to rent out heavy-duty equipment to dig out the hole where you're going to pour the foundation, you've got to buy concrete. I could go on and on and on. That's the cost we're talking about here. Let me tell you something. We're going to use in this example, we're going to build somebody a house, a $500,000 house. And we're going to try to make $50,000 profit off of it, all right? So we're going to bill him $550,000 even though we're only going to pay $500,000 in equipment and so on and so forth to build the house. That way we make $50,000 profit. Now keep in mind, you're going to have to hire people to build this house. That means payroll. That means another cost incurred to date. Now, when you make the initial contract, you make an estimate, and you hope you get it right, because if you don't, you're really going to pay through the nose later on. So you make this little contract, and it's binding, all right? So you say, it's going to cost me approximately $500,000 to build the house that this guy wants. And you tell him this, and he signs the contract, and yippee-yay-yee. Of course, you may later on figure out that, gee, it's going to cost you more than $500,000, but you can't really bill him that unless he agrees with you, all right? So you may get stuck with some extra costs, all right? So you have the most recent estimated total cost down here, which is what you estimated the cost is going to be, and of course you have the cost incurred to date, which was the actual cost that you're experiencing right now, and if you divide this by this, you get percent complete. So costs incurred to date divided by the most recent estimated total cost gets you percent complete. Now, you're going to estimate the revenue that's going to be made off this house. Now, this is not just what you're making in profit. This is what you're actually going to draw in to buy the materials to make the house, as well as the gross profit you're going to make. So that's what estimated total revenue is. And then you're going to have percent complete. This is how much of the house you have done over a particular period of time, usually about a year. Okay, so you're going to say, well, 20% of the house was completed in the first year, and 40% was completed the second year, and say 100% was completed the third year. All right? So if you take estimated total revenue times percent complete, you'll have revenue to be recognized to date. Now, how do you get this? How do you get this stuff here? Well, all right. That takes some explaining. All right. To get the most recent estimated total cost, you're going to take the cost to date plus an estimate of how much further it's going to cost to build the house. And when you add those two figures together, you're going to get the most recent estimated total cost. That's how you get that. All right, so you get estimated total revenue here. You take it times percent complete. Now, this estimated total revenue is what you agreed upon at the beginning of the contract. In this case, it's going to be $550,000. And we take it times percent complete, and we get revenue to be recognized to date. Now, you take this figure right here, this total revenue to be recognized to date, and you subtract revenue recognized in prior periods, and you get current period revenue. You take the current revenue, you take the current cost, you subtract the current cost from the current revenue, and you get your gross profit. All right, enough vocabulary. Let's just get to the nitty-gritties. Now, I'm going to move the camera again, so hang on just a second. And now you're going to start seeing my lovely face. Let's take this step by step. Shall we? All right. We take the first figure. And we're going to put this cap right over here. Now, I know this video is getting rather lengthy. It may end up being in two parts, so bear with me. If it is, watch part two. All right, you have $100,000 that you have run into in costs. Now, this is what it costs you in the year 2009 to build this house. We're going to start building the house in 2009, and we're going to have it completed by the year 2011. All right. Now, we already told the guy that the house is going to cost $500,000. Now, this is how much total cost is going to be to build that house. That ain't even including your profit. This is just how much it's going to cost to build that house. So you take what you've already paid for, you've already started buying hammers, buying nails, buying boards, buying bricks, so on and so forth, and this is how much you think it's going to cost you at the end of 3 years to build that house. You take this divided by this, and you get 20%. So now you're going to tell the guy, gee, this year the house is 20% built. All right. Now, then you're going to tell the guy